The Leader of the Third Party.
Thank you, Speaker. My next question is also for the Premier. Today in the gallery, there are parents from small towns and rural areas who are asking the Premier to save their children's schools. Schools in Lively, in Owen Sound, in the village of Long Sault are on the chopping block. Nearly 40 schools throughout rural Ontario are slated for closure. Rural students already have less access to music and health programs compared to students in larger centres. Now this government's going to make it even harder for these students to participate in extracurriculars, forcing them to attend schools outside their hometown and spend hours on a bus commuting each day. When will the Premier recognize the importance of rural schools and actually provide these schools the resources they need to stay open?
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. And I welcome all of the families who are here who are concerned about their local schools. I completely understand that, Mr. Speaker. And that's exactly why, since we have been in office, we have increased funding to rural schools, Mr. Speaker, even though there has been a reduction in enrollment, because we recognize how important those schools are. But to the Leader of the Third Party, it is the very reason that there needs to be a review of schools that sometimes there's an inability for school boards to deliver the exact programs that the Leader of the Third Party was talking about, those music programs, those art programs. Mr. Speaker, there needs to be a review to make sure that where there are some very small schools, where there can be consolidations, where kids are not getting the very best learning environment, that the boards work to make sure that that's the case. We're working with the boards. The Minister of Education is talking with the boards. But the boards know their communities best, and they need to make those decisions, Mr. Speaker.
Supplementary.
The boards need the help of the provincial government to be able to provide the services and the education that every child deserves in this province, Speaker. That's what the boards need. Schools are more than just bricks and mortar. They're actually parks and playgrounds, often the historical and cultural hub of a community. But last year, this government rewrote the book on school closures to silence community input and fast-track the process. They even included a loophole, Speaker, that allows a school to be closed within 2 months with no meaningful public input. When will this Premier stop forcing this closure of rural and community schools and immediately rewrite the guidelines to give communities a voice in the process?
Thank you, Premier.
Minister of Education.
Minister of Education.
Thank you, Speaker. And Mr. Speaker, I'm not sure where the Leader of the Third Party is getting her information from, but right now the school boards are actually going through a consultation process, an accommodation review process. They're actually talking to their local communities because, Mr. Speaker, the status quo is not sustainable. They know that some decisions do need to be made. These are difficult decisions, and it's important that a conversation occur between the school boards and the local community. And, Mr. Speaker, that is exactly what is happening. But I want to speak to the question of support for our local schools in rural areas, because, Mr. Speaker, we have, since 2012-2013, we've increased the annual grants for student needs funding for rural boards by over $199 million. A 5.79% increase. And these increases take into consideration, Mr. Speaker, the unique needs that are in rural communities to ensure that we can provide the good quality programs that every child deserves, Mr. Speaker.
Final supplementary.
Speaker, for all the claims that the Premier and her minister make about investing in education, parents, students, and educational workers just aren't buying it. Today, rural Ontario parents are at the doorstep of Queen's Park to say enough is enough. The geographic circumstance grant has been cut by $10 million in the past 2 years. This is money used to keep our rural schools open, Speaker. New Democrats know that where a child lives should not determine the quality of education or supports that they receive. We know communities, students, parents should all have a say in the future of their schools. Will the Premier actually listen? In fact, when will this Premier actually listen to parents and education workers who are rallying to save their schools today and take action to keep small and rural schools open?
Thank you. Minister.
Be seated, please. Be seated, please. Thank you. Minister.
Mr. Speaker, you know, we are listening to the concerns raised by parents. I just met with a group of parents and members of the community this morning, and I will join the Premier in welcoming parents who are here, because it's important, Mr. Speaker, that locally elected school board trustees have the responsibility of deciding where and how they provide education services to students of the board, including making the tough decisions around school closures or consolidations. Mr. Speaker, we are assisting in that by providing the necessary funding and supports to allow that process to occur. And Mr. Speaker, I just want to say that it would be financially irresponsible if nothing was done, Mr. Speaker. It is our responsibility to deliver effective programs to all students, and we must have these difficult conversations. And I want you to know, Mr. Speaker, that conversations are occurring. They're occurring with local municipalities, with parents, with students, and the boards will have that decision that they need to make.